The immediate past Emir of Kano and former governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria, Muhammad Sanusi, has again said it is inevitable for Nigeria to be bankrupt with its current governance structure, which he described as too expensive and unsustainable. The outspoken economist who has repeatedly complained about the costs of governance in the country, said with the fiscal crisis in the country is facing and looking at where Nigeria is headed post-COVID-19 crisis, it had become imperative for Nigeria to ask fundamental questions about the structure of its federation. Speaking at a webinar hosted by Emmanuel Chapel with the theme Mitigation of the Economic Impact of COVID-19 and the Path to Recovery, Sanusi said when he was the CBN governor and the price of oil was over $100 per barrel, the government at the time spent 80% of its revenue on salaries and overheads. To progress the conversation on the call by the former Emir of Kano, we have public affairs analyst and also an accountant, Alester Wilcox, via phone. Good morning, Alester.
Yeah, good morning, and happy Sunday. How do you do?
I'm well. Thanks for asking. Now, I'm sure the call by Sanusi may not be new, especially to many pro-restructuring. What is news is that it seems Nigeria is not ready to move forward. Or do you differ with Malam Sanusi?
Well, nobody will want to differ with Sanusi in its entirety, because Sanusi has been one person that has been vocal on a couple of national issues since he became a disease at CBN as governor. But the fact remains that maybe Sanusi is overplugging a dead horse and is not offering anything new. As a matter of fact, what Sanusi is not telling people is some of the fundamentals that give rise to some of the things that he's talking about. Because the truth of the matter is, we have three levels of government in this country. But each time our analysts talk, they always center on the federal government, neglecting what happens at the state and local governments, which are very, very partners in the Nigerian project in terms of economic and development of Nigeria. Look, we have a situation in our hands where, as a third world country, we have a lot of mouth to feed. And that is why you have a higher rate of recurrent expenditure. Because this money goes into so many. I am not satisfied. I'm not happy with that position. But the truth of the matter is, that is where we have found ourselves. And successively, we did nothing in the past to create that economic buffer and fundamental. And I think Sanusi should be one of the culprits. Because Sanusi has been out there for too long. He's been in the bank. Before going to government as CBN governor. So most of the elites, both in private and public sector, should be collectively held accountable. Mm-hmm. Because if they had always done the right thing, at Misho, we will not find ourselves in this country we will find ourselves today. Well, so there's nothing new in what Sanusi has said. I'm not trying to agree with him, but we must dissect these issues based on the critical fundamental that we find ourselves in. Then we can start making progress to find a solution.
But Alester, we see successive governments spend 80% on recurrent, and sadly, the large chunk is spent on politicians. Why can't we choose a lean government structure like, you know, unicameralism, reduction in ministries, and more?
Exactly what I said. I'm not happy with the situation, but we have found ourselves that because we have a constitution that was drafted by the elite. And I'm sure Sanusi didn't make any input when that transition was, and even though he was vocal at that time, I had also advocated a lean government. But the fact remains, are you talking about lean governance with respect to political appointees only, or lean governance with respect to the bureaucracy? Because most times we forget something critical, and that is the bureaucracy. Now, we have government officials, the politicians that fit fast. What is the number? Compared to the number of civil servants, that's the bureaucracy, the bureaucracy that servicing this position. Now, if you say cut down on lean government, fewer ministries, make it more effective, what about the other fallout, the unemployment fallout part of it? Now, government is trying as well as possible to solve two problems. First, to solve unemployment. Two, to provide fiscal infrastructure. It's a delicate balance. Because if you said cut down public and recorded expenditure, you are bound to affect the civil servant. Because really and truly, I must agree with you, and everybody will agree, we have an obloated civil servant. We have redundant workers in the civil service. Then what is the alternative? The private sector is not strong to create jobs for them, so government will always set in to create jobs, both at state, federal, and local government level. You won't believe that. You go to some local government. Some local government, you have over 2,000 staff. 2,000 in the local government that does nothing. That is where we find ourselves. We don't have local government now.
Let's look at what previous governments have done in the past. Former President Jonathan was criticized for bringing national conference at 11th hour. Now, shouldn't the present administration kickstart the process of restructuring or even adopt 2014 document?
We are talking about restructuring both economical and political. I don't want to care what Jonathan did at the 9 minutes or what his government is going to do. Every government has its own agenda. It's just like when you go to the United States of America, you have the Republicans who talk about capitalism and small government. And you talk about the Democrats who talk about big government and socialism, some quasi socialism for the people. So that is the critical balancing. Now the issue is this, I agree, we have an overbloated bureaucracy. We have multiple layers of agencies that could have done basically almost the same job. But how do you, at this point, create by destabilizing that area and then create unemployment? And the problem which we're talking about is, how do we increase revenue? Sincerely, if we have increased revenue, we will not be talking about overbloated public service. It's because we don't have revenue. The Nigerian problem is revenue problem, not the spiritual problem per se. If we have increased revenue, most will not pay tax. A lot of companies, both small and big companies, they cheat on tax, they cheat on VAT, they cheat on those areas that government wants to impose tax and collect taxes, both state, federal, and local government. So if we have additional revenue and we be able to manage certain areas, I agree. So because each time we talk about National Assembly. National Assembly, yes, it's one of the great fights we have in this country. But already, we have a constitution that's tied our hands, and the politicians are not ready, and the civil society are not vocal enough to push that agenda for a constitutional reform that will create either a unicameral legislation or a partial legislation. Mm-hmm. That is just the issue. But again, my dear, let us look at it critically again. If we have a budget size of about 7 trillion, budget size of about 7 trillion, both capital and recurrent, and the so-called National Assembly were always hammering on, has only 130 billion of about 7 trillion budget. Mm-hmm. And this is an organ that has just 125 or 130 billion. What is the, what okay, if you scrap it, what are you saving?